amateur cooks. Maundy Thursday is celebrated across all the world by Christians. And today, we're going to show you how the Pesach is celebrated across Christians in Kerala. So before I go into the Pesach dishes that are made by Syrian Christians across Kerala, I ask you to subscribe to our channel, Amateur Cooks. The week before Easter is known as Passion Week among Christians, and on the Thursday of that week we celebrate Pesach or Maundy Thursday. It represents the Last Supper that Jesus had with his apostles. So what they do in Kerala is that they all gather around in their ancestral home, and the eldest man of the family cleans the house. It is true that the eldest man of the family cleans the house, and on the evening of it, they all gather together, they sing their prayers and sing beautiful songs that are passed from generations by the Nasranis. And thus, they break the bread into 13 pieces representing the apostles. Also, they make the milk, which is also representing charset, an ingredient from the Jewish Passover. The Jewish Passover has got charset, which represents the mortar used by the Egyptian slaves to make buildings. Thus, it all has got symbolic meanings in it. So, we're going to make pesaha, appam, or the unleavened bread, which is not fermented. So, let's do this. The ingredients that you'll need for making pesaha unleavened bread are rice powder, urad dal. Urad dal has been fried and then powdered. We'll need coconut pieces for the garnish. We'll also need charlots and salt and water. And the other ingredient that we'll need is that we have made coconut into a paste. So these are the ingredients for making unleavened bread. So we'll add the rice powder. Then we'll add the coconut paste. I've taken one coconut. Then we'll add the urad dal. Then we'll add a pinch of salt. Now we'll add the water. We'll have to make it into a loose batter. We can see that the batter is now made. It is kind of loose. So now we are going to plate it up, and then you can either steam it or you can cook it using a fireplace by adding hot coals on it. So here we can see that I've taken a steel plate and garnished it with fried coconut pieces and also fried shallots. Now we're going to pour the batter on it and then cook it in a hot coal. So you can see that I've added the batter and then poured some fried coconuts again into it. Now you can either cook it in a steamer or you can cook it in a hot coal. The unleavened bread for Pesach, we make a milk which is similar to the charset that has been made by the Jewish people on the Passover night. So the ingredients that we'll need to make this milk is that jaggery, coconut milk, urad dal that has been roasted and fried and then powdered. We got rice powder which has been soaked in water. I've also added cardamom which gives the flavor. Now we'll cook it till it thickens up. So the milk is done. Now we'll serve it with our unleavened bread.